So we started doing the ponies 3 years ago, and I made, first ponies that I made were Dr. Hooves and Derpy. And we still make a Dr. Hooves and Derpy, but they've come a long way. We actually, the second year we did the ponies, we actually hired an embroidery service to embroider the eyes on, so it's a little better quality pony. The first year we painted the eyes on with acrylic paint mixed with fabric stuff, and it was okay, but it took about 500 coats to get the minky to stay down. The eye looked right.
Embroidery looks better.
The embroidery does look a lot better.
So you hired someone to do the embroidery?
We would actually send her, she was in her neighborhood, we would send her strips of fabric, and she had an embroidery machine, and we would go, these are the eyes we want. And so she would go ahead and embroider them, and then I would take the pattern and put it on top of the thing so that they would look better.
Yeah.
I've actually made ponies out of fleece before. It's a cheaper fabric. I made a giant Sweetie Belle for my then 5-year-old, and she squeezed that thing and squeezed it and squeezed it and squeezed it. What you find out with fleece is that it loses its shape. So eventually Sweetie Belle didn't look so pony-ish anymore. She was sort of giraffe-ish because she had a long neck and her legs were all spread out on the bottom.
What's this?
This is called Minky. In Houston, usually can find it for around $20 a yard. My son, who makes ponies here, he's found it for around $21. You can find it online, but I really like working with it because it makes a really nice stuffed animal, and it keeps its shape.
And it's soft.
And it is very, very soft. Okay, does anybody else want to make one of these? They just want to learn how to do it.
Yeah, I think it's worth $50. They're really soft.
Okay. So I will do this by way of demonstration, and then you can do it as we go. Okay.
Yeah.
I just said I'm going to do Octavia because we're going to BronyCon in a couple of weeks.
Is it 50 or 15?
Pardon?
50 or 45?
50.
Okay.
Yeah. It's $50.
Okay.
That's okay. Okay. So normally you're just gonna, as I said, stuff, so you're gonna take little pieces of the batting.
You don't use that whole bag for that one.
You would use that whole bag for one pony.
For that little one? You pack it in really tightly, I'm guessing.
You're gonna pack it super, wow, super tight. So as we do this.
What pound bag is that?
This is 4 ounces of stuffing. There are two different kinds of stuffing that you can buy. You can buy some that you stuff in that end up making a pony that's really pretty soft. And then there are, then there's kinds that you can stuff, and when you stuff it, it ends up being firm. And it's rock hard enough that you could actually hit someone with it and it would hurt. Yeah, they can get really, really firm. With the plushies and the sewn eyes, like with this Octavia, if she got dirty, I could just take her, throw her in a pillowcase, tie the top shut, throw her in the wash and dryer, and she'd come out great. So I really like using fabric. If you would like to actually make a pony, the kit is $50. I have some kits. We're making Octavia today. If you just want to watch, we've had some new people come in, you're welcome to do that too.
What kits do you have?
I just have Octavia. The last time I did it, I did a whole bunch of different ones, and this time I wasn't sure if we were going to actually do this panel, and so I just made a whole bunch that I could bring to BronyCon if I didn't sell them in the kit. So I just have Octavia today. Any other questions? So you're going to be stuffing this. You're going to use most all of this. You can have a pony that's actually softer than that. But if you stuff it that firm, it is actually going to
last longer.
Well, and it will hold its shape and it will stand up. The people, the last one that we did, one of the guys made his Pinkie Pie super soft. And it's not wrong to make them super soft. When we first went to BronyCon last year, one of the pony makers, she said she likes hers really soft, and the other one that's really pretty famous likes hers pretty soft. The other one's super hard. And so it's really a matter of preference. Okay, This is what it should feel like.
Oh wow, that is pretty. I got one to go.
So when you're stuffing them, this is what it'll feel like. Oh wow, it's gonna be very, very firm.
I wouldn't hurt to get hit.
Yeah. This one isn't actually our firmest stuffing. When I make this part, I make him really firm on the bottom because he's really tall, and I don't want him to fall over.
So
I can make him, you know, people tend to understuff. Yes, I do. It's called Doodle Song. And we brought some of our tiny ones up. So this is a pattern. I believe it's by ValleyViolet. You can go online and actually download her her patterns. I think she only charges maybe 10 or 15 bucks for the pattern.
What's the name of the model?
I think her name is ValleyViolet. I have to check with my son to make sure, but I'm pretty sure. And she does do a pony pattern. I've tweaked it into all different kinds of patterns. She's now done a mane and tail, and I used to just sort of have to design my own mane and tail pattern.
In case you decide you don't like it.
So anyway, a lot of it is just about stuffing. Does anybody have any questions while I'm just doing this mindless sort of thing right here?
So, how did you cut out the patterns and stuff like that?
You get the pattern downloaded from the internet, it will come on 8.5 by 11 sheets. And then you decide, do you want a stallion, which is a little bigger, or you want just a regular pony? And then she also has some manes and tails in there that you can actually, you'll download it the same way. Most of the pieces are really pretty small. If you have not done any sewing before, I don't think that doing this as a project, as a beginner sewer, would be very easy for you.
At least not with Miki. Miki can be hard to work with, right?
Miki's a little hard to work with. It does slide a little bit while you're doing your, while you're sewing it. But it's actually pretty.
What do you mean by slide? Just on the sewing machine and it'll go back to
The sewing machine has feed dogs that stick up like this on the bottom, and then you have the foot on the top. And normally the foot on the top is smooth. So when the feed dogs are pulling through the fabric, it doesn't pull them through necessarily evenly. So, sometimes you have to watch it. It's very thick. So as you know, there's some things that you're actually going to make little darts so that you can get some thickness with it. And so the little darts, sometimes you're sewing over other seams and that kind of stuff.
Yeah, it's ValleyViolet.
ValleyViolet.
Yeah.
If you guys would like to make a pony, we are making Octavia today. The kit is $50. If this is a hands-on class, or you can just watch doing it. I have plenty of kits. She's doing Pinkie Pie. That was left over from 2 weeks ago. But if you want Octavia, this is her kit right here, and you can actually just sell it. It's $50. We sell these at our booth for $75. So anyway, when you're done stuffing the back legs, and they need to be nice and firm so it'll stand up, then you'll do the front legs.
Who's standing up this bit?
And if you want a certain detail, like you can see this little detail here where the back leg sort of has this little dip in, you're gonna stuff just a little bit of stuffing into that little.
Oh, that's how you did it, okay.
Just a little tiny bit, and you just sort of shape the stuffing. The stuffing and the pony actually, when it's all done, you're going to be squeezing it and shaping it, and squeezing it around and making that stuffing move the way that you want it to move. Thank you. I appreciate that. That little thing back there, that one.
That's one of those little important details you don't think about until you're going, this is a bird.
I don't know what that thing is, and I don't know how to make it go the way I want it to go.
Yeah, when I started drawing them, I couldn't figure out where my legs didn't look right.
Yeah, it's like, I need that little bump right back there. So, we realize that there's no way you could make a pony in an hour. You can almost do this if you have a little bit of sign experience in an hour, but. Okay, for those of you.
For you to make one.
For me to make one, it depends on the pony. Usually about 3 to 5 hours, depending on the pony. Discord takes me because every single piece of discord has to be cut out individually. Normally when you cut out something that you're gonna sew, and you're gonna cut out two pieces together. With discord, you can't do that because he has an inside of an arm and an outside of an arm, and one of them's a lion. And then he has an inside of an arm, an outside of an arm, and it's a chicken. So, you know, he takes a lot more time because he has to be, every single piece has to be cut out. And then he's different colors, so you get a whole bunch of different colors before you can do that. For those of you who come in, if you want to make a pony, I have a kit. It is $50 to make the kit. All you have to do is stuff it, and you're going to do the hand sewing for the head, the mane, and tail. Otherwise, you're welcome to just sit and watch how it goes together. There's no way to actually sew it in an hour in this kind of a forum. You'd just be really, really frustrated. Yeah. So that's why we did the kits.
She has a bunch of different patterns, and they're all $10.
She has a whole bunch of patterns. They're like $10. And I've done the stallion pattern for Doctor Who's. We changed our Doctor Who's to have a yarn mane, just because he's an earth pony, and it just sort of felt like maybe he should have one. We did our Applejack with the yarn mane so that you can actually braid her hair and her tail. So there's a lot of different options that you can have with this. And it does take some time to get it done. How are you doing?
It's standing up without the front leg stuffed yet.
Good, good. It should. It's actually, yeah. The Pinkie Pie has that really, that sort of mane that sort of bounces around and then curls at the top. So yeah. That one's, yeah, and you'll stuff that a little bit too.
Yeah.
So, questions about fabric, where to get stuff, stitching, anything like that?
So you're from Texas?
I am from Houston, yes.
But your son lives here?
My son is in Utah, yeah. And my parents are here, so this is a good convention for us.
You know what places they sell Minky around here?
Not in Salt Lake, but if you go online, a lot of times the fabric stores will advertise that they do sell Minky.
Joann's is one of the best fabric stores. I've gone there for cosplay, and they have Minky.
I've also found that if you go online to Beverly's Fabrics, you can order it online. They have a great selection, and I believe it's $16 a yard, so it's worth
so
the shipping.
So much wider color variety.
Yeah. Yeah.
What are some stitches people could Google to learn how to make ponies?
Basically, all you need is straight stitching on your sewing machine. Okay. Like I said, the eyes we had professionally done. You can make them out of felt if you want to and stitch them on that way. We've painted them, I think that if you want a really nice pony, I think that the embroidery eyes are the best. But like I said, Beverly's Fabrics is where we usually get most of the Minky. They have a great selection of it. And then depending on how firm you want your pony to be. Now, they give you a poking stick with this stuff. It tends to go right through. It becomes frustrating because it's just
targeted.
You need
one on the end of the stick.
Yeah, well, yeah, you've got to really wrap it tight and then sort of plunge it down in there. So I think ValleyViolet does a good job of telling you how to actually go about stitching it. It's a little confusing at first because you're looking at it going, that's really a very tiny little dart right there. But it does, all of her patterns have worked for us. So
she also includes kind of instructable patterns?
She definitely does instructions too. Like I said, they're between, now she just came out with a new manes and tails pattern for an additional $10 or $15, which allowed us to have the mane and tail pattern for Pinkie Pie, for all the main six, and then a whole bunch of background characters too.
And she also has the princess patterns.
She does the princess patterns. My son actually makes the princess patterns. I'm not willing to do that because it takes too long. You can do, like I said, after you've done them a few times, then it'll become faster. When my son does them, he actually takes the pattern pieces, and on the inside of the Minky, this smooth part, he'll actually trace it in Sharpie to cut it out, and that makes it easier for him to slice them up.
So you don't use any zigzag or serging or anything, it stays just fine?
It stays just fine because they're all on the inside. the seams are all in the inside. They don't rub. Normally, like with if I'm making a shirt, I'd want to finish the seam because the seam rubs and then it's going to fray and all that kind of stuff. That doesn't happen with these guys. But you are working with quarter inch seams, so they're little seams.
Like quilting seams, those are hard.
Yeah, it's like quilting seams, basically. And then there's, a lot of clipping involved when you're going around a curve. Those are just, basic sewing things that you learn when you sew, to clip the curve so that it lays flat the way you want it to.
It's like basically cutting a little triangle into a circle or half circle so that the seam won't fold on itself and bunch up and cause issues.
Okay, so the first part of this is actually getting all of this stuff. And it does, you really gotta, push it in there.
So when you sew it together, where do you start?
When
you have all of it cut out, where do you start?
Okay, well, there's two sections to sewing this. There is this inside section here, and it's a piece that looks like this, sort of long, and then it has little leg cuts, and it's sort of the inside part of the pony. So you're going to sew the inside legs to this long strip that becomes this back part and the neck. So that's one section of it. And then you have these outside sections that you have to, there's some darts here, and then you're going to sew those together in the middle, and then you're going to put them both together with these seams here, and then inside. But again,
so sew the stomach part, then
the side parts, and then you put them all together into this body.
And then you sew along the spine, and then the sides of the legs.
And then at the end, then you're going to put these little round pieces on. So it does. It's a pretty small little thing that you're sort of putting together. And I've made them bigger. I've actually blown up the pattern and made them quite a bit bigger. But most people don't have room for a huge pony. They want some of them.
I know that.
It costs more just because it's not the stitching that takes a lot more time. It's that the materials cost a lot more when you're making a lot larger.
How many yards?
She tells you it depends on how you lay them out. I think that she says it's a third of a yard for a pony, but I'm not positive.
How much do you use for these size of ponies? Like how much fabric?
About a third of a yard.
Okay.
Because these are all the same color. Now when you have other ones, like our Dr. Hooves has the dark brown on the bottom. And then you can actually do a little hoof here that matches. If you do, every extra piece that you add adds extra time, and you just reach a point where it's no longer worth, no one's going to buy it anymore. It's part of economics. It becomes so expensive that no one's willing to buy it.
What about, have you ever done a shiny armor?
Yes, I have done a shiny armor.
Has the two.
The fetlocks?
Yeah.
I have done those. When we went to BronyCon last year, I did my first experimental Discord, and I did all the different little colors and all that kind of stuff. He just takes a really, really long time, and you sort of, you make it because you love the pony, not because you're going to sell it for what you put into it. So that's sort of the advantage of making your own, is that you put whatever time you want into it. Okay, so I've got a body here that's pretty good. Put a little bit more on the neck.
So it says the body fabric takes half a yard and the mane and tail fabric takes a quarter.
Okay. I think that I can probably get a little bit more in because I buy a whole yard and make a bunch of different ponies at the same time. So, but if that was her guide for that, that would be good.
That's just her basic.
Okay, do you guys want to pass this around to sort of see what that feels like when it's done?
Whoa. Pretty hard. Wow.
I've been making my pony plushie the wrong way then.
There is no right or wrong. Maybe you really like a soft little pony to cuddle, but... Well, it just depends on how you want it to be. Now, this one I have made pretty small to get the stuffing in this. Well, and this is a new way to make it. We used to just stuff the tails with the hole at the top of the tail, and she's recommending that you do a hole in the sort of middle so you don't have that stuff at the end. And I do have a stuffing stick. Once it's in here, you can sort of move it around a little bit. But again, if you want it to be super soft, you can make it soft. I mean, you don't have to have it firm, but most of the pony makers are going to make it a little more firm. And that one will stand up. So how are we doing?
She's standing.
Good.
I just don't have the rest of her body filled.
It takes a little bit to do. Okay, does anybody want to, do you guys want to stuff one? I mean, I don't care if you stuff them. Do you want to try stuffing one? Okay, come on up. I'll tell them at BronyCon. This is free labor, sorry. I guess that's not very nice. Training for information, just bring your chair on up. Here's the kit, you can just stuff a body.
Did you make these patterns?
I've made all of these, so that they'd be ready for today.
She bought the pattern.
Okay. I bought the pattern from ValleyViolet.
Because we actually have the patterns also, and we were making full
size. Oh, are you?
Yeah.
Okay, well, there's a body if you want to stuff it.
Hey, Octavia! Stuffing
Octavia.
See how far you get.
The, so
if you'll just roll that back like that, it'll get into the back of the pony a little easier. If you just want to see, I mean, if you want to, you don't have to finish it if you don't want it, but then you get sort of a feel for how much they, what they're like and how to work on it. I've done, my son is an engineer, so I say, he goes, this just needs to be vectored, Mom, and I go, I don't know how to do that. And he goes, no, it's really, really easy. I go, here's the pattern, do whatever you're going to do to it. So I have made a Dr. Who's that is this big.
Oh, wow.
And a Jerpy that big, because my daughter loves that shipping. I made the Dr. Who's out of corduroy, because like I said, I think that he's just really an earthy pony, and he just, and now I can't find the corduroy anymore, so now I make him out of minky, so.
I see she uses cotton on her examples.
She does cotton on her examples. My kids used cotton initially just to see how the pattern went together, but I think it makes an ugly pony.
But it would be a good starter.
A good practice, starter, right? To get a feel for it. The problem with the cotton is that it ravels. This stuff doesn't ravel while you sew. It just poofs because it's got fur.
What do you mean by ravel?
You mean unravel?
The fabric is woven like this.
Yeah.
And as soon as you cut it, it starts doing this.
It frays.
It frays. So the Minky does not fray. It fuzzes everywhere. Last year we made about, I want to say about 35 Flufflepuff.
Ooh, Flufflepuff.
And we sold every one of them, but I actually ended up having to wear a mask to do that because we got the nice long light pink poof. And every time you cut it, in my sewing room, it was just like, I was breathing it, and it was in my eyes.
I'd almost try to find
hair.
Shag carpeting and just use that.
Yeah. I just,
and brush out the shag.
Yeah, I just really, truly, by the time I was done last year, I went, I'm glad he's making his own Flufflepuff. I'm not making it anymore. We did meet him, nice guy. But, and of course,
like the creator of Flufflepuff?
The guy who does the comics, yeah. He was at BronyCon.
Mike or
something. Because I don't know anything about ponies, I'm just helping my kids out. Of course, there are a whole bunch of people. I met the guy who does Friendship is Manly, okay? And so he comes by, and my kids have shown me all of this stuff, and I'm going, okay, I can do this. I can do this. I can talk to these people. So this guy comes up, and I go, so what do you do? And he goes, I do Friendship is Manly. And I go, that's awesome. You know, this is great. And I go, and I couldn't remember which one it was that my kids had shown me because they'd shown me all these different, you know, things. And I go, so who did you get to do the voice acting for that? And he just smiles at me like, and he goes, there's no words, it's just music. And I went, oh, I am so sorry. So then my kids come back to the booth because they had been taking a break. And I go, I just met the Friendship is Manly guy. And they're going, so what'd you do? And I said, I just put my foot in my mouth. But he was a nice guy. Okay, so when you do get ready to fluff, do the head, she has this little bit of a nose here like this. And in order for you to get that little bend of a nose, that's done with a little piece of stuffing. So you're gonna ball it up.
So how did you sew it so that she would get that bend in the nose?
It's part of the pattern. And then a part of making the shape that you want is the stuffing and just squeezing it, putting in it nice and tight and getting it, you know, getting into the shape that you want. Yeah, like, you know, the little curve on her tail, you know, I stuff stuffing all the way down into the little tiny curve of her tail. So, and then this is my bag of stuffing. By the time I'm done with the head, it will be gone. We're pretty darn close. We had people when they were making these, like I said, had leftovers. So yeah, we've met a lot of different people. It's been fun to do conventions. It's fun to go meet people. If you haven't been by our booth and got a free button, please come by and get a free button. My daughter does all the artwork.
Is it that one?
It's Doodle Song in the vendor room.
That's in the hall, so you'll go down here.
So it's in the vendor hall.
Yeah.
And we decided to do that last year because it was just really fun to meet people. Fortunately, I have an extra bag.
There's art right here, and then there's over there.
And she does artwork. She actually was a vocal performance major. She sings opera and minored in art. And so this is her art side of her just sort of coming out in a very fun way. And my son started sewing. He loves extreme sports. And he actually does the extreme kite flying, kite surfing, kite boards and stuff like that. So I told him, I said, I'm willing to buy you two kites, you know, a couple different kinds of kites. And I said, but what are these kites you want to buy? And he goes, well, Mom, you have to be over 18 and you need to sign a liability waiver. And I went, what, for a kite? It looks like a parachute. So anyway, so my husband got that for Father's Day, because that's what my kids do. Hey, Dad, don't you want this kite? Isn't that going to be cool for Father's Day? And then after that, I told him, I said, I am willing, and this is the head, so we can pass this around so you can sort of feel that. It's a little softer than the body, but it's got to sit on top, and we don't want it to get too heavy. So I told him after that, I was willing to buy him as much fabric as he wants. And so he got online and he would find all these kite patterns and they really do look like parachutes. And he started sewing. And that's why he got into this, is because he actually sews better than anyone in the family besides me. So.
Okay, so how do you sew the holes?
Which holes?
Like the hole on the tail and connecting the head to the neck when those are all powdered instead of.
So they're all done by hand.
Pulled it out.
So the reason I sewed these kits ahead of time is because those are all the sewing machine sewing. Now I'm going to show you how to do this by hand. So this part, what you're actually going to do is, I first started learning self-sculpting sewing when Cabbage Patch Dolls came out. And one of the things that they did was they brought out this needle about that long. It's a soft sculpting needle. And the thing that's sort of interesting about sewing these is it really doesn't matter what kind of thread, what color thread you use, because you're not going to see it anyway. So, and my eyes have aged. I don't need them all the time, but sometimes it's just. The head is actually going to be a little soft. You can feel it's a little softer than the body is.
Yeah.
Now, my son is super into knots. He uses it. And when we were teaching this class together, he was teaching them one knot, and I was teaching them a different one.
There we go.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't stuff the ears at all?
Nope. Those are already sewn into the head by the time you've reached this point.
And you can have the not basically not trim the internal seam as much, and you'll get the little edge on the ear.
When you're doing that, when you're doing these seams in here, you have two choices. You can either sew it to the head gusset right here so that the ears are even, or you can sew it to the side of the head. The stallion pattern's a little different in that. In this one, this head gusset goes up and it's rounded and comes back straight to the back. On the stallion, it's actually a little easier because the gusset comes all the way through from the front to the back, whereas this one, you stitch the seam, and then it's a little tricky to get this to line up so that the ears are even.
So you typically sew it to the middle piece?
I sew it to the head piece, and my son sews it to the middle piece. So it can be done either way. So anyway, at this point, we're going to... if you do not sew this little neck flap over the top, then when you squeeze this pony, the stuffing from the inside of this can actually go up into the head. So you're keeping them into two separate things by sewing this together. So we're going to actually just stitch this top. How are we doing over there? Okay, good. And you've got the head all done. Okay, you're going to put just a little bit of stuffing in the mane and tail so that it holds its shape nice. And because her stance straight up.
Yes, like she has three pieces, not just two.
Right.
I'm trying to remember which ones are which.
I did not bring our Luna pony that we normally make, but the Luna pony has that big mane that comes out the side. And then you have one that comes out the bottom, and then, I mean, it's a three-piece mane. And so, like I said, our pony prices are based on how long it actually takes to put the thing together. And, of course, the materials.
And you do custom ones, right?
My son does custom ones. I don't. He's the one that's really patient. He's actually done all of what are the flying group that Rainbow Dash is
always?
The Wonder Bolts.
He's done the Wonder Bolts. He's done the Luna's Guard. He's done a whole bunch of them. And he's super, super picky. And so he'll rip out little seams because this one did it. This one was off by 1/16 of an inch. And I said, you're making a $75 pony. It's not worth it. He goes, no, no, no. It's got to be perfect. So the engineering part of him, if people come to the table, if I have any of his ponies, and he has his own business, and I go, what are you going to sell this for? I'd sell it for X. And he goes, oh, I think I'll sell it for this. And I said, oh, that's ridiculous. I'd never do that. And he goes, that's the difference between you and me, Mom. I go, okay. It's that, Mom thing. Okay, so he is not here. Actually, what happened was we ended up having TrotCon this weekend and Crystal Mountain at the same time. Mm. And my son has done Crystal Mountain the last 2 years in my daughter's place. Oh, that just broke. And so he went over to TrotCon and she came here so that she could sign artwork and stuff. So they've been best friends for a really long time, so it makes sort of fun for them to do this together.
Quick question. What you're sewing on the head over, like you're covering it up?
What I'm going to do, that little neck part that I just did is just sort of stitched. It doesn't have to be pretty because it's inside the head. And then what will happen is when you stuff this head, you're going to take your thumbs and you're going to push in here and open up the center, this little center part right in here, so that the way that you put the head on is you're going to just cram it in there, and then you're going to stitch it around the outside here. So that puts your pony together. And then what will happen is this is the tail for Octavia, and you can sort of see you have this little point here from the gusset underneath. The tail's going to get attached right here. And then the mane will get attached right here. So in the end, you'll have a sweet little Octavia. And then you can accessorize it however you want to. We actually made Applejack at the other one that we did. So everyone's off to Hobby Lobby or Joann's to buy little straw hats and red bows and all that kind of stuff. So does anybody have any questions? It's really a fun project to do. It's going to take you... The reason I said my son's initial one took 10 hours because he's never done stuffed animals before. So you're going to have to be a little patient with yourself to sit down. I don't know that I'd make it out of Minky the first time. You may want to make it out of a fleece, just because the fleece is going to have a little bit of give to it. It's going to have a little stretch, more so than the cotton will, and you'll get used to working with the thickness. It's just that as a long term, if you're playing with it and all that kind of stuff, the fleece tends to pill a little bit, it tends to lose its shape a little bit, and the minky will not. Now, we actually do make a pony out of velour, which is, they don't really call it minky, but it's just a shorter. The one that I did this year that I love is bulk biceps, because I gave him the big vein in his arm. The front of his body's really bulky, and he's got a little earring, he's got a flat top. You know, so I'm always looking for something that's just a little bit different, because I do get bored pretty easy sewing the same thing over and over again. But my kids used the money for college, so I went, I can help out. Saved me a little bit. So any other questions?
How did you do the vein?
The vein?
Yeah,
it's just soft sculpting, and you'll just use this long needle and tie a really good knot here, and what you do is, you'll go in, like if I'm gonna sew a vein on this one, I would stuff this a little softer, and then I would just go in the side, and then you squeeze it, and then you're gonna sew back and forth.
It's kind of like you're trapping some of it in the
right, exactly. Okay. So depending on what you want, depends on, you know, if you want that vein. The first one that I did, I gave him some pecs, so I soft sculpted down the front of him so that he had those real big arms and there was vein and some pecs, and this is actually hilarious. I love this.
With Discord's Eagle Claw, it's got the rings on it. Did you see the stitches?
The reason that Discord is more expensive, he's $250, is because I have to soft sculpt the lizard part on the end, which, you know, it's somewhat similar to this kind of pattern, but you actually squeeze and you put your needle, long needle, back and forth, and then you wrap. So you're going to go back and forth in the same spot as you squeeze to keep it, and then you're going to wrap it around, and that gives it. And if you want to come by and look at him, I can show you the soft sculpting part. With the chicken hand, you know, I have a brown piece of fabric, and then I had a whole other hand to do, and I had to wrap that and make them into fingers so that, you know, it looks like it claws. And again, as you do this, if you notice, I just keep squeezing on him so that she ends up being the shape that I want her to be. If you see a pony that's, you know, like this, it means they have too much stuffing under here. You know, lighten up on that stuffing under there and really mold this so it ends up being the shape that you want it to be. Now, with ValleyViolet's pattern, I actually added a little bit of length to the front two legs when I was doing their pattern. I did her pattern last year as it was, and this year I've actually made these two legs a little bit longer because I found that by the time I got the head and the mane on it, it would feel like this, you know, be tipping over because it's too heavy. So if you want to lengthen the legs just slightly on the pattern, then it won't fall over so easy. So anybody have any questions? Want to come up and touch anything? A soft sculpture stitch.
Yeah,
if you go onto YouTube is amazing for this kind of stuff. Look up soft sculpture, fabric soft sculpture, doll soft sculpture. You can, like I said, I started out sewing Cabbage Patch dolls, so you had to put the little, you know, cheeky things and the dimples and the little hands and all that kind of stuff. And I'm sure it would show you on there how to do it, but your tool that you're going to need is one of these really nice long needles. I did cotton quilting thread with this initially when I was making them, thinking that because it was heavier, it'd hold a little better. It actually broke. The cotton polyester is actually a stronger thread when it's doubled up. So you will want to double it up and stitch it on.
Can you show the sewn on the head?
Sure. I broke my thread and start there again.
That's why I said just...
You know, it's just sort of, you know, here. Just want to make sure that we don't get kicked out. Are you about to that place to sew that?
I sew to the body.
You're good. Just keep stuffing. So, usually when you sew this, you're going to do an anchor stitch, and you're going to sew in like this. And an anchor stitch, whenever you're putting anything on your pony, which includes your manes, tails, and your head, you're going to do an anchor stitch, you're going to back stitch in the same place three times.
Did you tie a knot again?
I did, but it doesn't matter. When the first time I made these, I thought that I'd anchored it really good because I had this humongous knot that I thought, oh, nothing's going to happen. Pops right through. Any kind of pressure on it pops right through. So you do have to backstitch in the same spot three times. When you begin, when you end, when you change out thread, make sure you backstitch three times. And I actually pull on it to make sure it's not moving. Because there's times when I've done it, oh yeah, I got it, and then it just moves a little bit more, and I go, ah, okay. Stink. Okay, head goes in here. And I anchor this to the neck first. And then it's sort of a, it can move on you. When we did this class, we had a guy who did Pinkie Pie, and by the time he got all around the circle, the head was like this. So you have to keep checking, and you're just sort of gonna take little stitches back here. I don't know if you can see that or not. And you're gonna make little X. And the minky actually is a pretty.
The neck to the head, the head to the neck.
Yeah, and you do the same thing. Back and forth a couple of times, make sure it doesn't move. Now, the center gusset for the back of the head goes to the seam in the back of the neck. So you keep the head straight, and then the center of this seam here goes to the center of this. Now, my son also likes to turn the pony's head so that it looks in another direction, because that's him. And so you can do that too. You can put the head on however you want to. If you want it to be straight, this is how it's going to be. And I'm right-handed, so I'm going to move to the left from here.
So you do an X where the two bottom are 50 to the neck and two top.
You also learn very quickly that if you're sewing through a seam, it's really hard to push the needle through. So you're going to sort of want to look around that. And I like to sew it two or three times just because we had one guy. And he'd taken one of our ponies and he started playing football with it, and he came back and, you know, the head had come off. And it was like, I said, I can fix that. He goes, okay, that would be good, because, you know, his head just came right off. And I went, so then I started watching how it was being used. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, when you pull on the head that hard, probably is going to fall off.